And what is that supposed to mean, offbeat?
Well...
No, wait, I think I know exactly what it means. Offbeat is in cheap. Well, excuse me for not being rich enough to shop at the International House of Tidass like you and Maris the heiress. That is what you meant, right?
Yes, but I had no idea you'd pick up on it.
Aren't you the cutest little thing? Oh, yeah, give me a kiss, give me a kiss. Oh, I love you too. Oh.
There, happy now?
How can you just toss him aside after such a tender display of affection?
I can do it with men too.
So I stood in the hallway trying to decide whether to, you know, come back up here with you guys or take my chances in the pitch black streets with the muggers and the weirdos. So I went down a couple of flights. And then I changed my mind.
Okay, you're right. We're on the voyage of the damned.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Wozniak. I know the balcony is not for sex play.
Shut up, you big doily.
Sounds great.
At least I have my own sense of style. You won't even buy a chair unless some fey French aristocrat has set his fat satin fanny in it.
Louis the 14th was not fey. Everyone wore garters in the 18th century.
Why are you doing this to me? Look, if you have a tumor...
Roz, stop it!
Oh, here we go. He's a tennis instructor and his name is Brick.
Dear God, Frasier, Sven, Gunther, Brick.
Excuse me, but I've dated all these guys.
Well, where do you think I came up with the imagery?
Listen, you little titmouse.
I was wrong, Frasier. Your way is better.
I have got to have some chocolate!
It's kind of a celebration.
You know what it's really good on? Scrambled eggs. And pizza. And potato skins.
Yes, Roz, welcome to caviar.
You don't have any on you, do you?
No, we're expecting some momentarily.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. You think it'd be good on a cheese Danish?
Oh.
I think it would. I'm getting one.
I assume at the next meeting of Seattle's Haven't Kissed Roz Club, it'll just be me and the Archbishop.
I'll save you the club dues. Come on, Frasier, why don't you pull up a couple of chairs and tell me about it?
I'm calling the cops.
The hell you are. This man's tips alone have probably paid for all the pot you'll ever smoke. Just back off, cowboy. And that goes for the rest of you, too.
Roz, what exactly does call screening mean?
It means I get to put on the air the calls I want to hear.
This isn't exactly my milieu.
Okay, let's make that lesson number one. If you're going to use words like milieu, you might as well show up here with a sore on your lip and a couple of kids. Personally, I think you'd make a very sexy gladiator.
Roz, this is not for me. It's for my brother, Niles.
Oh, well, in that case, make it a gladiola.
I'm not interrupting anything personal, am I?
Yeah, Niles, we just eloped. I'm your new mom.
Oh. Well, I'll be a son of a bitch.
Yeah, you know what Barry was doing from 10 o'clock until midnight
what?
Last night? Me, that's what.
You don't even wrinkle the sheets, do you? I always had a thing for evangelists. And there was this young preacher who had a show of his own on Sunday mornings. He spent hours trying to save my soul.
And?
And it worked, and now I'm a nun. What do you think happened?
Does one still wear a white sweater jauntily tied around the neck to these things?
If one wants to get the crap beat out of one.
I can't believe any of my guests could be a multiple murderer.
That's easy for you to say.
I can't believe any of my guests could be a mobbable murderer.
Oh, yes, and by the way, I frown on overnight guests.
Then you're not doing it right. Go. Go do that. Get married. Have a couple of kids. Move out to the country. Buy a puppy. Live happily ever after.
Just don't tell me about it. I need a boyfriend.
One thing led to another, and we have a date tonight. Ministers aren't celibate, are they? Not that I don't love a challenge. I once had 3 dates on a single Saturday and still had time to defrost my refrigerator and rotate my tires.
If
you're not at least this tall, you can't go on this ride. When you invited me, did you say brunch from hell or brunch from hell?
Oh.
Wow. Do you really think she's planning to do the barracuda?
Hello.
Hi.
Are you here alone?
Oh, God, I hope so.
A natural childbirth needn't be painful.
It needn't be, but it be.
Will you people stop? You are torturing me. I could report you to Amnesty International.
I am pregnant, and you told my crazy mother, and my Christmas is ruined, and I'm too fat to even be Mrs. Santa, and I hate this holiday.
Bite me. I need something to kill my appetite besides your stupid, ugly face.
I want my show to be fresh and spontaneous and call screening squelches, all of that.
And the mystery of Dave's departure deepens. Buy me a Mercedes and I'll make your neck look like a relief map of the Andes. My hair is flat. Never have a good date when my hair is flat. If it's flat after, that's a good date. You don't actually buy all this no sex stuff of hers, do you?
Yeah.
Well, it's war! What kind of vicious, judgmental, name-calling, machete-mouthed bitch are you?
What do you do when the romance goes out of a relationship?
I get dressed and go home. Wonder Woman really is my hero. I mean, she's smart and beautiful, moral, and totally independent. I had somebody. A guy I really liked. And then we broke up. God, Frasier. I miss him so much.
Now, what kind of deal would you give me if I bought 100 rolls?
Well, I'd take off 20%.
And what would you take off if I bought 5,000 rolls?
Everything but my bracelets. No one is more careful than I am when it comes to birth control. But then again, even the best protection is only effective 99 out of 100 times. I can't beat those odds. For your information, classic rock is both classic and it rocks.
What happened to you?
I'm old. What is going on?
We have a stuck junkie.
Why did Chunky stick his arm in there?
Oh, that's it.
Roz, do you have a tissue?
If you don't see it, I don't have it. I'm sorry. Thank you, Bulldog, for your offer. But I'm uncomfortable with it, as I would prefer to cut my own arm off and eat it.
At 20, you can do anything.
Hey, there's still a lot of candy left in this piñata.
Daphne, if the jewelry wasn't that good and the sex wasn't that good, what have you really lost here?
You've never worn that sweater on a Tuesday before.
I've asked you to take your hands out of your pockets when you talk to me.
Listen, you sleazy little lime tick, you do that one more time and I'll cut you off. And I don't mean mid-sentence.
Stop it, you're scaring me.
So are you going to say it, or are you going to make me wait till the end of the day?
Say what?
Happy birthday.
It is not your birthday. Oh, God. Oh, God, it is. Oh, Roz, I'm so sorry. God, let me take you out to lunch or something after work, okay?
You are so easy!
Oh, that's it. I'm out of here. Guess what? Thriving Seattle night spot is closing its doors.
Roz, you're moving. Are you quite finished undressing him with your eyes?
Oh, please. I'm already looking for my stockings and trying to remember where I parked my car. Is he cute?
It's hard to tell from a driver's license photo, but he is 5'6", weighs 200 pounds, has corrective lenses.
Leave it on the floor. All right. I wouldn't say no to a sandwich.
He didn't want to date me. He wanted to convert me. I don't have anything against religious people. I don't care if they're Jewish or a Jehovah's Witness or a Buddhist. I am ecumenical. I embrace men of all faiths.
Frasier, I gotta go.
Oh, all right.
But let not either us be strangers be.